Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm filming the TikTok palette tag that was created by Samantha March and Allie Glines, I believe is her name. They did this as a collab on their channels, and then I actually did this as a collab with my friend Britt Clark here on YouTube. She has an amazing YouTube channel. I'm sure you guys have all checked it out already. If you haven't, I will go ahead and link her in the description box. Definitely feel free to check her out. So we already answered all these questions as a live on her channel, but in case you guys don't have a spare hour and a half to watch us talk about our palettes, our answers to these questions, I decided, hey, let me just film this as a quick little video to throw up for you guys. So the first question is, what is your newest palette? And I just got these. You guys would have seen these on my Instagram stories. Now, by the time this goes up on my channel, I've probably already gotten some other palette, knowing me. But for now, these are the newest palettes in my collection. These are by the brand Shared Planet. I thought these were so cool. I saw somebody mention these in some kind of video, and I wanted to check them out, and I added them to my list of brands I wanted to try in 2020. So the brand is called Shared Planet, and I haven't heard too much about them, so I thought they'd be the perfect thing for me to pick up and review. And they had an Earth Day sale, so I took advantage and bought these together. They are available in a bundle, so that was a little nice, and I was able to save a little bit of money, so I did pick it up. But this is the neutral one. This is called the Tiger Collection. Okay, so it says, inspired by the tiger and its natural habitat, Shared Planet's Tiger Palette mixes a range of 12 rich neutrals, browns, and deep green with rich, lustrous golds. Much like the tiger itself, the palette combines a mix of warm, matte, and striking shimmer shades that blend seamlessly to create endless looks on all skin tones. So I'm so excited for this one. I believe Nicole Guerrero and Kristen Dominique are like brand ambassadors, and Nicole Guerrero had a whole video on the Tiger palette because she actually got to go to India and see the tigers. So I thought that was really, really cool. So I'm kind of interested in supporting this brand. I haven't heard too much about them, so if you guys have tried them, let me know. And this is the Polar Bear palette. I was so interested in this because, if you don't know, my husband loves bears. They're like his favorite thing. I love picking him up little bear figurines all the time. It's such a beautiful cool tone palette, and it kind of reminds me of the Pat McGrath cool tone palette. I think it's her first palette, the $125 palette. So this one says it's inspired by the reflective icy hues of the Arctic. Shared Planet's Polar Bear palette combines a selection of 12 richly pigmented shades ranging from brilliant violets and diamond blues to stunning metallics in silver and rich black. Combine the shades, blend seamlessly to create the perfect cool tone smoky eye. I don't know, these just seemed really, really cool. I'm very interested. I will definitely do a first impressions video for you guys, so stay tuned for that. Okay, so the next question is, what is your oldest palette? And for my oldest palette, I did pick this one. This is my oldest palette. I purchased this in the spring of 2009, and I remember the whole story, but it was my first spring break, actually going on spring break, and I got the opportunity to go to Hawaii with a friend, and we went to Hawaii, and I just got my tax return. I was feeling like a rich bitch, and I got so excited because I went to, I think it must have been a Macy's, and I don't even think I'd really been to a Macy's before, or like a nice Macy's, because our Macy's doesn't have like a makeup, well, we have like Clinique, but not like an Urban Decay counter and stuff. So I got to an Urban Decay, this guy was doing makeup, he did a full face, sold me like $400 worth of makeup, which is a lot of money as a college student. I don't even know what I was justifying that as. Maybe that I just never owned makeup and it was so wonderful to have like stuff that matched my skin tone and this like cool new brand and all that. So I bought this palette and it just has such good memories. It's so cute. I can't remember what this is called. A lot of people told me in my live with Britt, but isn't it so cool? I mean, this is like the Urban Decay everybody misses. And then look at all that baby pan in there. Like, I could have probably used this up if I didn't start YouTube and get severely addicted to makeup, but oh well. Okay, so the next question is, show us your most expensive palette. I would have to pick my Pat McGrath. Now, I do believe the Metropolis is more than the price of one of these, but I have all of them that have come out so far, so obviously this is like the most expensive section in my makeup collection are my Pat McGrath palettes. I love these. I wouldn't trade them for What wouldn't I trade? I mean, I would probably trade them all for the Metropolis. I do really like the Metropolis palette, but these palettes are beautiful. So let me really quick just show them to you guys one by one. I'm sure you've all seen these, but just in case, and people ask me all the time if Pat McGrath is worth the hype. I personally think yes, but it's such a personal preference. I do think that Natasha Denona has some gorgeous everyday formulas. So if you don't like to sit and fuss, I think maybe Natasha Denona could be more suited to you, but I think Auntie Pat has definitely included everyday shades in her collection as well. So it's just like a fun treat for me. I love these as much as some people love the Tom Ford quads. So just what makes you happy. Just do what makes you happy. And if you can't afford them right now, doesn't mean it's going to be forever. And sometimes she has really good sales. So just take advantage of those when you see them. Okay, so the next question is, show us your most affordable palette. So I decided to go with this one because I had just gotten these. These are $5 at the drugstore. They're by the brand Profusion. And I mean, who doesn't love a good $5 green eyeshadow palette? I just love how much green eyeshadow has like made its way into mainstream, and she's cute. I need to use her. I haven't actually tried this yet on my eyeballs. I just think it's so great that we can do such fun color schemes at such good prices. I know they have a purple, they've got tons of them, and they're also now sold at Walmart. At least like my little Walmart in Fargo has it, so I'm assuming a lot of you guys' Walmarts carry Profusion too. Okay, so the next question is, show us your everyday palette. And I can't honestly show you an everyday palette because I use so many different palettes. I review palettes on YouTube, so I'm always typically trying something new. But if I had to pick like an everyday palette, it would be the Corderosa. I'm obsessed with this. It's so beautiful. This is by Sigma. If you guys haven't seen it yet, I don't know how that's possible because I feel like everyone's raving about this palette right now. And it's honestly stunning. I am so impressed with Sigma's eyeshadow palette quality. And look at these shades. The promo shots that they released of this palette did not do it justice. And then I think we saw people getting it in PR and everyone just like lost their freaking mind because the shadows looked so much prettier in the PR photos that people were posting online. So then when I saw Kelly Gooch use this, I totally grabbed it and I'm so, so happy I did. I literally went from owning zero Sigma palettes to owning two Sigma palettes in a week after I tried the Corderosa. I had to get my hands on the Enchanted palette, and I do have the Enchanted palette. I've used it once so far and it is so good, such a good formula. So very, very happy with both my Sigma palette purchases at the moment. Okay guys, so the next question is the most colorful palette. Now, I definitely have a lot of colorful palettes. In my live with Brit, I did show the cake palette. So just to kind of give you guys a little twist, I do have this one too. This is the Carnival palette by Be Perfect. And I saw so many people rave about the original Carnival palette that I decided to pick the second one up because I just heard so many people rave about the original. If you guys can tell, I've hardly used this. I think I've used this palette one time. So I figure if I put this in this video, you guys can tell me if you're still interested in hearing about this palette. This is a collaboration between Be Perfect and Stacey Marie, who I believe is a UK-based makeup artist. So I love the aesthetic of that palette. Okay, so I decided to feature the e.l.f. Bite Size palettes as my smallest palettes. These are technically also the most affordable palettes in my collection. They're technically quads, but I still feel like they count as palettes and great price point. I also wanted to show you guys that I do have a little Kaja bento box. I just think this is so adorable. I know there's so many YouTubers that like love these. I think they're okay. I think that since I have the all shimmer one, I don't use it as much, but if I was just like a non-YouTube person, I think I would get so much use out of something like this, especially if you have the one that has a matte shades in it with one shimmer. You could do a whole eye look with this little guy. And like, how cute is that for travel? So adorable. Okay, so the next question is, show us your biggest eyeshadow palette. And I had to pick this one. I mean, this is actually physically the biggest. I held it up against all my other Morphe palettes and it is. So this is the Morphe 39L Hit the Lights palette. This was their holiday palette of 2019. And it is one big old Bubba Palette, and I haven't really used this since I reviewed it for my channel, but I know some of you did get this based on my recommendation. I'd love to know what you guys ended up thinking of it. I think the neutrals are really nice. Didn't really love that colorful quadrant. The formula wasn't as good, but the highlighters were beautiful, and I thought this was really nice and full of really fun neutral shades. So my palette with the best memory is my Mani MUA Makeup Geek collab palette. This guy is such an OG palette. It actually has some pretty big dents in it. I wanted to swatch these actually just to see if they were any good still, but I actually ended up wearing this palette on my wedding day, so I have like a little eyeshadow palette memory. Wow, this still swatches really good. I have a eyeshadow palette memory box, and this has been sitting in there for some time now, just because I'm never gonna get rid of it. But look at how beautiful that shade is. And I mean, I think we always knew this palette was gorgeous. That's why the people that bought it purchased it. But man, it makes me think of my wedding, and me and Brittany definitely talked a little bit about our experiences doing our own wedding makeup in the live video. So if you have time, definitely would recommend watching it. I will link it down in the description box for you guys. But yeah, that was my wedding palette, so that's why I chose it to represent my makeup collection in the question of best memory. Okay guys, so the next palette question is, show a palette that's worth the hype. And I had to pick the Natasha Denona Metropolis palette because this is undoubtedly my favorite Natasha Denona palette. This one, I think so many people that own this will say this is such a good deal, such good formulas. The other thing I do love about this too, and I forget to mention this when I show this palette, but each quad is set up so you can do a whole eye look with a quad. So if you are not very good at color theory, or you don't have time to think about like what shades should I reach for, you can just do eye looks with each of these sections, and it's so freaking cool. Like, the amount of thought she would have put into making this palette is unbelievable, and it's just so good. I could sit here and talk about it all day long. I would love to do something with this palette in the future, so let me know if you guys would be interested in me reviving this palette, because I love it so much, and it does not get enough use in my collection, but it's so beautiful, and it's totally worth the hype. Okay, so for my palettes that are not worth the hype, I did end up picking just the KKW brand in general. I think these are okay, but I think you can get these neutrals at like ColourPop price points, so I feel like you're definitely paying for kind of the name and the packaging and stuff like that. These aren't like the worst for tan girls, but they are very like lackluster. They are very like everyday. I love to use these on my friends when I do their makeup. Like, these are beautiful for like brides, proms, special occasion type stuff where you don't need like crazy green eyeshadow or like super duper colorful eyeshadow. I can really turn out like a very neutral look with these, which is why I still have them in my collection. I want to keep them if I ever need to do eyeshadow on my friends. These would be the ones I would reach for, and like Anastasia palettes, just because these are the colors like people wear on like a regular basis if they're like not on YouTube, you know? And I like the vibe. It's very like minimalist, so I get that. But as far as like my perspective, are they worth the hype? I don't think so. Not for that price point. Okay guys, so the next question is, show us a palette that is a favorite from a favorite brand. And I could not narrow it down, so I decided to show you guys all of my little Kaleidos palettes. These are so good. I'm so inspired by these color combos. I love them all. I wanted to say I love them all equally, but that's not really true. This one would be in second place, and then all the other ones would be in first place, just because I think they're so fun and unique. This one is so beautiful. This is my favorite from the first three they launched. It's like the purpley, bluey one. Oh, that color combo is so pretty. And I swatched these on Brits Live, and then I just did a look with this one for my collab with Morgan Turner. And that eyeshadow look, you guys really, really seem to enjoy. And these shadows perform really great, so I was really happy with that. A lot of people seem to not know much about this brand, which I'm surprised about, because I feel like so many people talk about it that I didn't want to like overdo it. So if you guys have any questions, if you want to see me use these more, definitely just ask me, because I'm more than happy to do that for you guys. I like this brand. They sent me two palettes in PR, and I think I'm on their PR list. I think I can safely say that now. And I would love to help you guys if you have any questions too, because I feel like this is just a brand I love. Even if they weren't sending me things, I would talk about them and buy from them. And I think that's so important with YouTube, because so many people's content is dictated by what is sent to them in PR. And for me, the love runs deep with these guys. And so if you guys want to see more of these, I would be more than happy to do eye looks with them, because they're so stunning and I want everyone to own these, because I think they're so fun and unique. And so can't wait to see what they do in 2020. The last question is your most used palette. And technically I could show my Urban Decay Naked palette, because that one is a hot mess and I've hit pan on multiple shades. I just wanted to talk about the Modern Renaissance instead, because this is one I still use a lot on, again, my friends and stuff when I do their makeup. So I just wanted to show you guys this. It's definitely got the most like dents in it compared to a majority of the eyeshadow palettes in my collection. So this one's just an oldie but a goodie. I can't say I reach for this as much as I used to, but I definitely remember a time where I was a slave to the Modern Renaissance palette. Not gonna lie, I was a huge stan of that palette. That is it for all the questions of the TikTok palette tag. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like I said, I've already filmed this with Britt Clark, so if you want to see like a 1 hour long version of it, you should check out her channel. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will catch you in my next one soon. Bye!